Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to connect PostgreSQL database with the help of Spring Boot. So let's get started. So the prerequisite of this video is going to be you must have PostgreSQL's pgadmin, IntelliJ IDEA and Java installed on your system. So once you have done that, just Google Spring Initializer, you'll be getting the first link, click that. And here we need to configure the dependencies and other properties that we want to add in our project. So I am fine with Gradle Groovy, Spring Boot version, and I don't even have to change the name. If you want, you can just change the name of the project or something. I'm fine. I will go with Java 21. And next, here we will be adding some dependencies. So click that. The first one is going to be Spring Web, which is used to create the REST APIs. And the next one is going to be Spring Data JPA. And since we are using PostgreSQL, we need the PostgreSQL driver. And the final one is going to be Lombok. So we will be requiring to use the getters and setters. So by using Lombok, we can avoid the template or boilerplate code, okay? So these are the four things, and just click on generate. So it'll be getting downloaded as a zip file, and go to your downloads and just unzip it. That's it. So if you go inside that, basically you'll be having the necessary code inside it automatically created for you. Now just open IntelliJ IDEA and click on open. Go to your downloads. You need to go into that folder, the demo folder that you have extracted now. Click on OK. Trust project. So you'll be having source folder, expand it, main, Java, and we'll be having our demo application. So I just set up SDK, and yeah, so it takes some time to index, so just be patient till then. So once everything is done, let's begin with our code. Okay, so first thing is we will be making an connection with our PostgreSQL database. So for doing that, you'll be having the main resources application.properties. So here we need to add few properties which enables us to connect with PostgreSQL database. It's going to be spring.datasource.url, and here we need to specify our localhost path of which PostgreSQL is running. So it's going to be /localhost. By default, PostgreSQL runs on the port number 5432/. And here you need to specify that, okay, it's SQL, I left a yes here, yeah. So to be careful, if you make even a small mistake over here, you won't be able to connect it. And here we need to specify our database name. So go to PostgreSQL pgadmin, you'll be having the databases, okay. Right click, create database, and just name a database, it will be demo post. And this is going to be the username, okay. Postgres, this is the username. So just save it. And I've got the demo post created, and it's currently empty. It doesn't even have any tables inside it. So that's fine. And just specify the name here, demo post. That's it. And next is going to be the username and password. So copy this. It's going to be username Postgres. That's the username we saw earlier, dot password. So this is going to be user specific. You need to specify the password that you had over there in the Postgres database. And final thing is going to be spring.jpa.hibernate.ddl-auto=update. So this is also necessary. This basically helps us to reflect all the changes that we make in our code immediately into the PostgreSQL table and column. So it's also good to have this. So just type this out first. Once you are done setting these up, the next thing is going to be we'll be creating our entity. So in this tutorial, I'll be just showing you how you can create a table, okay? So we will write the model for the table in our code, and if we run that, the table will be automatically created in our demo post database. So that's how we can verify our connection is successful. So for doing that, again go into the Java folder, and you'll be having the example.demo. Here right click, click on new. It's going to be a Java class, and let me just name the table as person, or the class name as person. This is fine. And next is going to be the columns. So you need to specify what are the columns that are going to be present in our table. So it's going to be private long ID, and it's going to be private string name. I think I'm good with this too for now. And you also need to annotate the person with at entity. So through this annotation, we are specifying that this class corresponds to a table in demo post database. All right. And next is going to be the data annotation from Lombok. So we need to add getters and setters. So set the value for this ID and name that can be avoided by using Lombok, the data annotation from Lombok. That's it. This is fine. And next we need to add a primary key. Okay. So that's going to be done with the help of ID. So this specify that this long ID is the primary key. Okay. And you need to import it from jakarta.persistence. Okay. The ID should come from here. And you can also have a generated value. So this is basically like, you know, auto increments. We have some things. I will just go with a random one. Strategy equal to generation type dot identity. Yeah, this is fine. Just auto increments the value, to be honest. Yeah, so these are fine for now. So in case if you don't specify a table name, it will automatically take the name of the class as the table name in PostgreSQL database. So for specifying a custom table name, you can just add the table annotation, and it's going to be name equal to, here we can specify the table name. I'll just go with table underscore one. This is going to be my table name. So this is good. Now we are done with our entity code. And final thing is going to be the repository. So repository is basically a piece of code that connects our table to the PostgreSQL. Okay. So through the repository only, we will be able to perform the insert, update, delete operations, the object of a repository class. Okay. So now let's just go here, right click, new, and Java class. And repository is going to be of type interface. Okay. And let's just name it. It's going to be person repo. And we have got it. Now we need to extend, and we need to link our person class to the repository. So it's going to be JPA repository, the first one. And here we need to specify two parameters. First is going to be the class name, which is person in our case. Just type person, and comma, the data type of the primary key. So the data type is going to be long, because ID is the primary key of our table. So it's going to be long over here. So that's pretty much the code. If you want to perform insert or update operation, you need to create a service. But since this video only covers the connection, we are just fine with this now. So now if I go to PostgreSQL and my demo post, now you can see I'm not having here any tables. So after we run this code, and if there aren't any errors, and if the connection is successful, we'll be getting a table automatically created. So that's a live proof of our connection is successful. Okay. So now for running this, you need to go to demo application, the main file, and we just need to run this and run. And now you can see I'm not getting any errors, which means that our connection is perfectly done. And the port number 8080 is the default port on which Spring Boot runs. And if you are getting any errors over here, you must check your application properties. You must have made some mistakes over here. So now if I go to pg4admin and the database demo post, and if I just right click the tables and refresh it, and here you can see we're having a table underscore one, and the name directly corresponds to the name that we have given over here for our entity class. And if the expand this columns, we're having two columns. One is ID and name. So we have got the necessary columns also created and the table also created, which means that we have successfully connected our Spring Boot to our PostgreSQL database. And I hope you have found this video useful, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Run a lot of CRUD operations by using Spring Boot, PostgreSQL, MySQL, and MongoDB, and other API tools and AI tutorials also. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.